At the home, what teachers make that are not. All of my poems are based in truth. That it is based on an actual event. It was a New Year's Eve party, that's not important. The lawyer who insulted me does exist. He probably would not recognize himself. He would look at my name and say, oh, I know that guy. He's the friend of a friend of a friend. He was hosting the party. He had 250 guests at his parents' amazing brownstone on the Upper West Side. He's 6'5". He's very good looking, especially in his tuxedo. He had teeth like a drive-in movie screen. And when he probably didn't say, be honest, Taylor, what do you make? That's probably me the next day writing a poem. But he did try to ask me what my salary was and use that as a justification for why anyone who would willingly take that job must be so stupid they shouldn't be allowed to be a teacher. But when he did ask me what I make, in the moment I said, a little over $28,000. The poem, What Teachers Make, is wish fulfillment. I wish I had been as smart as this. And before I started, those of you who are filming, go ahead, start filming. Just get a shot of everybody who is around here. Get a sense of who's here. We're in a ballroom in Las Vegas with 416 people. It's a gift. I can't be honest about that. It is July 21st, 2016, and here it is, What Teachers Make, or Objection Overruled, or if things don't work out, you can always go to law school. I would probably be reciting this poem at almost every gig I do until the day I die, and that is fine. Because there's only one thing worse than having one poem that everybody wants you to do, and that's having no poems. He says the problem with teachers is what's a kid going to learn from someone who decided that his best option in life was to become a teacher? I'm sorry. He reminds the other dinner guests that it's true what they say about teachers. Those who can, do. And those who can't, teach. I'm sorry. I decide to bite my tongue instead of his and resist the urge to remind the other dinner guests that it's also true what they say about lawyers, because we're eating after all, and this is supposed to be polite conversation. I mean, you're a teacher, Taylor. Come on, be honest. What do you make? And I wish you hadn't done that. Asked me to be honest. Because you see, I've got this little policy in my classroom about honesty and ass-kicking, which is if you ask for it, well, then I have to let you have it. You want to know what I make? I make kids work harder than they ever thought they could. I can make a C-plus feel like a Congressional Medal of Honor, and I can make an A-minus feel like a slap in the face. How dare you waste my time with anything less than your very best? I make kids work, oops, I already said that. I make parents tremble in fear when I call home at around dinner time. Hi, this is Mr. Molly. Hope I haven't called at a bad time. I just wanted to talk to you about something that your son said today in class to the biggest bully in the grade. He said, hey, why don't you leave that kid alone? I still cry sometimes, don't you? And that was the noblest act of courage that I have ever seen. I make parents see their children for who they are and who they can be. You want to know what I make? I make kids wonder. I make them question. I make them criticize. I make them apologize and mean it. I make them write, write, write. And then I make them read. I make them spell. Definitely beautiful, definitely beautiful, until they will never misspell either one of those words again. I make them show all their work in math class and then hide it on their final drafts in English. I make them realize that if you've got this, then you follow this. And if somebody ever tries to judge you based on what you make, you give them this. Here, let me break it down for you so you know what I say is true. Teachers make a difference. Now what about you? Thank you.